Hello everyone, welcome to Education Lecture. In this video, I'll be teaching you the last and final 14th poem, that is Water, written by Challapalli Swarupa Rani. If you are new to my channel, then subscribe my channel to get further new updates. And as I told you in my previous videos, I won't ask you any questions regarding the author or the poet. It is same with this poem also. So after reading each stanza, I'll be telling you the summary of each stanza. So let's get started. In between, I'll be telling you the meaning of the unknown words also. Just as the water knows the ground's incline, sloping, it knows the generation's old strife, very angry quarrel, between the village, upper caste, and the Vada. Vada means Dalit, that is lower caste, like the dampness wet on the wall's edge that never dries. It knows that untouchability never disappears. So here the water knows that from many generations, the upper caste and the lower caste difference has not yet gone. Still, many people see the discrimination between the upper caste and the lower caste people. Like for example, they are only giving that in the well, in the wall of the well, right? When we often take water from it, some water will be spilled on the wall. So the wall will be always wet. So it never dries. Like that only, water is giving an example that here the untouchability also never disappears. Like the wetness on the wall doesn't dry. Like that only, the untouchability never disappears. In short, if I have to say about the whole poem, because it is too big, right? Many stanzas are there. In short, this poem speaks about the untouchability between the upper caste and the lower caste, and the caste discrimination, and the importance of water. That's it, this poem tells about. So next stanza, second one. The water knows everything. It knows the difference of race between the Samaria woman, non-Jews, and Jesus the Jew. It also knows the subcaste difference between leather and spool, cobblers and weavers. So here I have to say that main thing is water. Water is only telling about whatever water has seen so many generations. Whatever the things he has seen about the discrimination, importance of water, what kind of peoples are there, about that only water is only saying. So they have told, see, the water knows everything. Here also, just as the water knows. Okay, so water is only telling whatever it has seen. So it is saying that the difference between race, the caste difference. Like Jesus, he was a Jew, and Samaria woman is a non-Jew. So there was a difference. Then the subcaste. In caste only we have subcaste, right? So those also, they make difference. Like leather and spool, both they use for shoe only. Like for example, shoe is the caste. And under that, what are the things used? Leather, spool. Those are like subcaste. So they have told, like the difference between leather means cobblers and spool means weavers. So those are like, really means similar, same only. But still there is a difference in subcaste also. The race difference is there. So third stanza, it knows the agony of the Panchama. So here also water knows the agony means pain and sufferings of Panchama, that is fifth class, untouchable or Dalits. Here also it is a lower class. In the classes like first class, second class, the upper class, then lesser than upper class, like there, it is there, right? So in that fifth class, that is Panchama. So detail they won't ask you. Just to know, I am saying fifth class, and it is an untouchable class, or it is Dalits, lower caste, who, not having the right to draw a pot of water, waits all day near the well with his empty pot until a Shudra arrives. So Shudra here is a little like a fourth class. His fifth class means he is a little higher in caste. So now here is many people during before the time, people were standing near the well to draw a pot of water, but they were not allowed due to the upper caste, that caste discrimination. Upper caste people would not allow the Panchama, that is lower caste people, to draw water. In simple words, you have to say is these people, upper caste people, or that lower caste people would just what to say, pollute the water. Means they come and draw the water, it will make just pollute, as many know, right, what are the caste difference. So they thought like that is, so they were not allowed to take. So they were waiting still all day, means till evening or night, when a Shudra arrives. So a Shudra should arrive. That means nearly to the upper class, like a fourth class or in between fourth and fifth. So that person should arrive and he should take the water and give to these people. Then only they will be able to take water from the well. So this is the third stanza. Fourth stanza. It knows the humiliation, insult or shame of the Vada girl, that is untouchable, when he who poured the water from a distance falls all over and touches her. So here the Vada girl, she is also an untouchable girl, as many upper caste people think we have to not touch the low caste people. You to just something they will tell, like some polluted, something will happen. Their thinking is like that. Okay, something negatively they think about the lower caste people, in simple I should say. Means. So here when a Vada girl, when a low caste girl comes and take water, to fetch water, when she comes, she is not allowed. So a person, a man, here they are given he, so a man or a person pours water from a great height. Means here they are given same. For example, they pour from such a height that she should take water. So while pouring like this, all over her body, it falls, and these people just touch her, you know, right? They touch her because she is untouchable. They just insult her. So she is not able to take water from there also. So this is the fourth stanza. And the fifth stanza, it knows the righteous rage. It means refers to water, as I told. So rage means anger of Karma Chedu Suvarthama, who opposed the Kama landlords, that is high caste class people, with her water pot when they asked her not to pollute the pond water. And the water is witness to centuries of social injustice. So here, they have given behind the poem. Yeah, behind the poem they have given here about Karma Chedu Suvarthama, a Dalit writer writes it. Two youth were washing dirty buckets they had used to feed their buffaloes in the drinking water tank in Madigapalli. This was objected by a Dalit boy, which angered the youth. They were about to beat up the boy when Munangi Suvartha, if I am spelling it wrong, please forgive me, I'm sorry. A Dalit woman who had come to tank to collect water tried to protect the boy from the attack. She lifted the vessel she was carrying to ward off the hunters. Her attack of lifting the vessel was a self-defense. This led to attack on Dalits. So two youth come and they come to wash their dirty buckets in which buffaloes would have eaten their food. So they come, there a Dalit boy, as they know, right, what are the importance of water. So he thought they are polluting their drinking water. So he is very angry, the Dalit boy. So these youth get angry and they come to beat up the boy. That time this Suvarthama lady, woman, comes and she protects the boy. She would have a vessel, she would be carrying a vessel to fetch water. That time when she sees the boy, when the youth were attacking, she takes her vessels and for her self-protection, she hits them. So these upper caste people got angry upon the lower caste and they attacked this Dalit people. So around 6 Dalits were killed. So dominant means high caste, pity means very small. Okay. So these they won't ask, just for information they have given who is Karma Chedu Suvarthama. So they will ask you 1 mark or 2 mark questions, that's all. So yeah, who opposed the Kama land law? So Karmacheta Suvatamara, she opposed the high class people for with her water pot. So I told like a self defense she did with her water pump for the because they polluted the pond water. So this they will ask as a paragraph question. Why did she oppose? Okay. I'm sorry if they may ask. You can just for information can read that, but this para is more than enough to write a paragraph answer. So when she for her self defense she told to not to pollute the water pond water. The water is witness, so water knows everything. What had really actually happened? 2 centuries of social injustice, practice of untouchability still now continues. So from 1st to 5th para, the role of water is, it is a witness, symbol of purity, discrimination between low caste and high caste. As I told, right, caste discrimination. So the in these 5 paragraphs, that only they say. Paragraph, no, sorry, stanza. This full poem is in like that. Majorly, they tell until the 5th stanza. So, when I see water, that is Challapalli Swarupa Rani, when she sees water, she remembers how my vada, that is untouchable, that means lower caste, which would thirst all day for a glass of water. So, these untouchables, lower caste people are not to... and were not allowed to take water from the pond, right? So they have to be thirsty for a whole day for a glass of water. For drinking water, they have to wait till a Shudra arrives. So this is the 6th stanza. 7th stanza, for us, that is Dalits, Vada, lower caste, everything is same only. As water is not simply H2O. As you know, right, the chemical equation of water is H2O. For us, water is mighty movement. It is the Mahad struggle. Which was the mighty movement? Is Mahad movement. The Mahad movement at the Chadar tank. A single drop of water embodies tears shed. All the sufferings and pains over several generations. In the many battles we fought for a single drop of water, our blood flowed like streams, but we never managed to win even a small puddle, pool of water. So there was a mighty movement led by Dr. Ambedkar near the Chadar tank, and that Mahad movement was in a small town in Maharashtra. This they won't ask, just for information I'm saying. So that had happened, they fought. Dr. Ambedkar and his supporters fought for not getting a single drop of water. So they fought in the battle to get a single drop of water, but still they didn't get a pond of water also. But their blood flowed like streams. So blood only, many were many were killed in this battle. Next 8th stanza. When I see water, that is Challapalli Swarupa Rani, when she sees water, she remember how we welcomed our weekly bath, lower caste people, as if it was a wonderful festival, while the entire village bath luxuriously twice a day. This is high caste. So welcomed a weekly bath, weekly once only these lower caste people were taking a bath. But these high caste people, in a day, twice they were bathing luxuriously because they had water. And these lower caste people were not allowed to take water from the pond also. So weekly when they are bathing, it was like a festival for them. But these high caste people, daily they used to bath twice a day. Then again Challapalli Swarupa Rani, when she sees water. See, they have given I means it is Challapalli Swarupa Rani. Here they have given it means water. So simplify it, I am saying. So when she sees water, she remember her childhood. When she walked miles to reach the big canal and carried back heavy pots with the muscles and veins on her necks, straining, bursting. So you might have seen in a few, in few movies, or you can go to just Google and see in a villages how they carry water pots when they walk from their house to the lake and from lake to the house. So they used to carry them on their necks. So they have to do a mile walk, such a long they had to walk for a long time to take one pot of water from the big canal. So they were so struggling for getting a pot of water, and it was too heavy, and their muscles and veins were just bursting, means it was paining a lot for them. So ninth para, she remembers it touched roofs aflame, that is a fire accident. The Mallapalli burning to ashes for want of a pot of water. Mallapalli is burning to ashes. So the huts were burnt. When these were burnt, they didn't have water like this lower caste people, and the high caste would also not give. So the Mallapalli village only was fully burnt because of a pot of water. Because there was a shortage of water, they could not rescue their own village. So it was a fire accident. So this is a 10th stanza. I'm sorry. 11th stanza. Water is not a simple thing. It can give life, but it can also devour lives. That is to consume destructivity. The water that refused to quench parched throats, satisfy dry throats, became the killer tsunami wave that swallowed whole village after village. So we have to not think of water is a simple thing. Okay, so it may give life also, it can destroy our lives also. Sometimes to satisfy our dryness of our throat, we consume water. In the same time, the water also will become a destructive thing which will bring tsunamis to the village, and the whole village would be destroyed. The 12th stanza is just opposite. See, the poor are but playthings in the vicious hands. Often it turns villages into dry desert, and sometimes it drowns them in floods. So water may be positive, water may be a negative thing also. If it gives water, it gives at one shot, or it won't give the water at all. Means water is not there. Means all the land will be drought. It will become into dry desert. If it gives at one shot, everything will drown into flood. So both the things are there. So water is the poor are but like playthings. Poor, what they can do? They can't do anything, right? They can't save themselves. So these two stanzas are destructive nature of water. How water can become a destructive thing also, and how can it be useful also. So this they have talked about destructive nature. Next they will talk about what are the uses of water. So the role of water, life giver, so it will give life also, and life destroyer. 10th and 11th para. If you say 12th stanza also says that only. I'm sorry. So it may give lives also, it may destroy lives also. In short, if I have to say, these are the two lines. So next, 13th stanza. Between the village and the vada, between one state and another, this water can ignite many struggles and strife. Ignite means provoke or give rise to many struggles and conflict. It can make blood run in streams, but it can also sit innocently in a bislery bottle. Innocently means harmlessly. So between many villages, that is upper caste and lower caste, between a state and another state, there is always a war between the water, the want of water. Every state, if one state is having water, we have to surely give to other state. But if we only don't have water, proper water supply, then how can we give? So the other state would come, give rise to many struggles. They may be against us. So water may cause a war also, make a conflict, and make blood run like streams. Again, there would be a war, and many people would sacrifice their lives for water. Okay. And If it gives like this, if it gives a negative thing like a destroying or giving a war, and a positive thing for it is a, it can sit innocently, means without harming anyone. It can sit in a Bisleri bottle. As everyone knows, right, a Bisleri water bottle comes. So it can sit innocently in that also. It can, it can rage a war, or it will sit innocently. So both are there. As I told, right, there are both positive and negative things for water. Next. This water from our village well that forces us to do many a circus feat. Now slowly, what is this? Sarastiously. If I am spelling it wrong, I am very sorry. Very secretly, dances its way into Pepsi Man's bottle with its new name, mineral water. It takes to the skies, it raises a storm. So circus feet right here, we have studied, right, how they have to carry their heavy pots. Same, how the women used to balance the pots. So they have to balance the both the pots and come. So very secretly and very easily it comes to Pepsi Man bottle. As you know, right, many villages only there are these beverages, that is the cold drinks companies are located, because these villages will have a lot of water supply, and from there they absorb just the whatever water is available to them, and they build this beverages factory. So their name is Pepsi Man's bottle, and the other name newly for water has come is, that is mineral water. I think everybody knows what is a mineral water. So it takes to the skies, it raises a storm. It takes to the skies means, first one is served when flying up in a sky or airplane. So when you go to aeroplanes, they serve you this Bisleri water bottle, so mineral water. So they serve, so it is rising the sky, means it is available, water is available in the sky also. Second is, it has become very popular, means it refers to the controversy regarding the bottling plants or industries for mineral water and beverages, which has resulted in depletion of groundwater, which affects the Dalits directly. So as I told, right, due to the beverages, these industries which are located in the villages, these Dalits are directly affected because the groundwater is fully absorbed. If you want to study detailly about it, you can just Google it, but they won't ask you detailly about it at all. So just, you know, so that it affects the Dalits directly. So raises a storm. It affects, right. So next, 15th century. Now, water is no mean matter, not a small matter, okay? It is a multinational market commodity. So, you know, right, water is needed everywhere. Everywhere in the world, water is needed. And because of this water only, these beverages industries are still there. They have a demand in the market due to the water. So, it has become a multinational market commodity. As you know, right, many kinds of beverages are available. So, here, role of water, it is a market commodity in this stanza. And the last stanza, as they say, water is omniscient, knowing everything. As I told, right, water here knows everything from generation old stripe. It contains the world. So, the whole world, you know, right, our earth is full, surrounded with water and land. So, water knows everything, whatever is happening around the world. Omniscient means knowing everything. Omnipotent means all-powerful. Omnipresent means present everywhere. So, water is present everywhere, water is powerful, and water knows everything. These two words I want to ask just for a meaning I am saying. So, this is your end of this summary. And behind they have given, in short I have to say about the poem is, the poem is about, they say, a role of water, cruel attitude of the high caste people, all the sufferings and humiliations the low caste people had to undergo. So as I told, same. And these are the, I hope you can see, yeah. These are the one mark question answers, which are often repeated. As I told in all my videos that if you know If you understand every poem, every lesson, story is more than enough to write your brief answers. If you want to take a note, you can take a note, or else you can just pause the video, or you can read it, whichever is comfortable to you. While going to your exam hall, if you take a glance at it, you will just remember the story, whatever it I have told. As I told in my summary, always I will tell only the major and main points, and those only I have written as question and answers, 1 mark question and answers. If you understood or didn't understand anything, or you have any teaching problem in this poem when I was teaching, you can comment in the comment box, which will encourage me to do my further more videos. And yeah, I forgot to say, in my next video, I will be uploading the job application, which is very important for your board exams or public exam, whichever. So I will be uploading in my next video, which will be very useful for you. Yeah. You may think this poem is too big. No, no problem. It is not at all big. If you know the stories, more than enough. And as I told, right, they tell about the caste discrimination, importance of water. That's it. And what are the difficulties faced by low caste people due to water. And if you know the story, you can easily write your paragraph question and answers briefly. So these are your essay question answers. So like, share, comment and subscribe to my channel to get further new updates. Thank you.